2 Samuel chapter 9. David said, "Is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake?" And there was of the house of Saul a servant whose name was Ziba. When they had called him to David, the king said to him, "Art thou Ziba?" He said, "Thy servant is he." The king said, "Is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show the kindness of God to him?" And Ziba said to the king, "Jonathan hath a son who is lame on his feet. The king said to him, "Where is he?" And Ziba said to the king, "Behold, he is in the house of Machir, the son of Amiel in Lodebar." Then King David sent, fetched him out of the house of Machir, son of Amiel, Lodebar. Now when Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, was come to David, he fell on his face and did reverence. David said, "Mephibosheth." And he answered, "Behold, thy servant." David said to him, "Fear not, for I will surely show thee kindness for Jonathan, thy father's sake. He will restore all the land of Saul, thy father. Thou shalt eat bread at my table continually." And he bowed himself and said, "What is thy servant that thou should look upon such a dead dog as I am?" The king called to Ziba, Saul's servant, and said to him, "I have given unto thy master's son all that pertained to Saul and to all his house. Thou therefore and thy sons and thy servants shall till the land for him. Thou shalt bring in the fruits thy master's son may have food to eat." But Mephibosheth, after son, shall eat bread always at my table. Now Ziba had 15 sons and 20 servants. And said Ziba unto the king, "According to all that my lord the king hath commanded his servant, so shall thy servant do. As for Mephibosheth," said the king, "he shall eat at my table as one of the king's sons." And Mephibosheth had a young son whose name was Micah. And all that dwelt in the house of Ziba were servants unto Mephibosheth. So Mephibosheth dwelt in Jerusalem. For he did eat continually at the king's table, and was lame on both his feet.